Hi everyone, Sarah here. Welcome to the Croft Curse. Now, I know I've not done a game for a while. To be honest, I've just been incredibly lazy and whatever. I really don't. Well, I do care, but why haven't you been doing games, Sarah? You lazy person. Anyway, let's go. I have been live streaming, so no, I'm not dead. Anyway, moving on. The Croft Curse. Let's start. Now, this black screen is supposed to be a diary entry, but for some reason my game won't let me read the diary entries, so we're not gonna read them. I'm sorry. Exit out that. It'll get a cutscene. And then we have to... swim forward. There's a hole here. But then we've also got to lure the sharks away from a gasoline tank that's here. So now we go back round. And then we drop into that hole. And then we swim forward. And then we climb out. Go forward and Lara speaks.
Oh no! I told Anaya to stay near me, but she just had to swim away. She got into the tomb, but I need to find a way in.
So we need to find a way into the tomb. So... go up to the ladder and climb up it. And when you get to the top, drop, immediately grab, and then press forward and crouch to crawl into the crawl space. Drop into the water on the other side and come over here to an underwater lever. Pull it. This drains the room and also opens the way to a fire room. Go in and jump to the first block. Draw guns and... from here you might be able to just... shoot the gem in the lion's mouth. That opens the gate in an underwater passage. Back where we came from. Now we need to jump to the next block. We're going to jump to the next one. Immediately stand jump to the next block. And then we have to sort of run and jump to the next block and grab it. So we've got a slight left curve as well. So run and jump left and grab. And this is the secret. Two medipacks, one large and one small. We need to run and jump back to the next, to the previous block. And then we need to stand jump to the next block, but I'd wait for the fire to go out again. So I'm going to save it again. Up to the corner. Stand jump to the previous block. We're going to jump to the next block and then stand jump with a grab in the air to land in the entryway. Go forward, climb up into the crawl space again, exactly the same way as you did before. Whoops. That was me. And swim forward. Also, if you look in your inventory, you'll also have the harpoon gun and a diving weight. Now we are going to drop back into the shark-infested waters. Swim forward. Keep going straight. Left. Left. And follow the passageway. You can't really go wrong, it's just a long passage. Up and climb out into a room with a burning bowl. Obviously avoid the burning bowl. Drop into the next room. Now we need some items. So first things first, we are going to go into here. And climb up this block. Turn round, jump to the next block. Turn round, jump to the next block with a grab. Climb up. And then we jump into the next room. Go forward. In here you have to avoid the skeletons and pick up a water skin in the back of the room. Out. Drop to the right onto the block. Hang drop to the floor and just drop. You can do this without losing health. Re-enter the previous room. And we need to pull this cage. We're pulling this as far as it'll go. And then we are going to pull it underneath that hole up there. So we need to pull it. No, Lara, I said pull it. Thank you. Then we need to go around the other side and push it. Come on. Are you going to cooperate? Thank you. Then push it. And then climb up onto the crate. Then climb up into the opening. Then go around to the right and take a bone from the floor, which is also a torch. Drop down onto the crate, drop down to the floor, light the torch on the bowl in the previous room with the ledges. And then re-enter this room. Drop the torch. In the next room, do not save in between putting the element items on the pedestals, question mark. Anyway, those things, these things here, because you will have a risk of losing the item, so I wouldn't save. Go back in here. Use the empty canteen on the water. Now what we're doing is we put the water on. That's the water done. Now we do the sand on here. And then we do the gasoline on here.
No.
Yes. We all live for the day for her to say yes. Pick up the torch. And then light it on the center one. The gate ahead opens.
Stay back. I'll go down there.
Drop the torch. Drop into this area. Come to the right quickly. And climb out. Roll. Avoid the head at the top because it will kill you. Is the shark dead now? Yeah, okay. Go through this next room. Climb up the other side. Oops. There we go. And I'm going to show you what's in here. We have a little wheel that we need to get. We haven't got it yet, as you can see. What we need to do is go back into the previous room. Don't fall into the spikes, whatever you do. We have now got to go back into the room with the head, who's being a lot more aggressive than previous times I've done this. So drop into the pool. You can pull the lever, but I don't think it does anything. Just take the little wheel. Just for completion's sake, we'll pull the wheel. And then climb out. Climb back through this area. Avoid the hole again. And then climb up the other side. Over to the right, where we use the wheel. That then makes the big wheel turn. And it also floods the spike area here. So just be careful when you're falling into this and quickly swim out of the spikes as quickly as you can. Or just try and get us over the top of the spikes and then just swim into the other room. And then pull the underwater lever and swim back out, avoiding the spikes. That underwater lever lowers that golden block inside the room with that deadly head. Climb out over here. Drop into the water. Quickly go and collect the box. And the level will change. You'll get another diary entry, but like I say, we're not going to be able to read those. Thank you very much for watching, everyone, and I shall see you in my next video. Bye, everyone.